for genuine reforms. A pre-talk with Aung San Suu Kyi must be followed by a substantive and time-bound political dialogue. So if the regime is serious for the national reconciliation, the first action that must be taken is the unconditional release of political prisoners and ensure the participation of these political prisoners in the political process. More than 2,000 political prisoners remain in the Burmese jail and continue to face the mistreatment, abuses in prison. We received several reports of political prisoners suffering from the severe health problems caused by inhumane and harsh conditions in the prison. Regime continued to practice torture during the interrogation and use prisoners as porters. Even though they are signaling words, signs for the reconciliation, they don't stop arresting people. Just yesterday, 46-year-old man was arrested for staging a solo protest in front of the Chinese embassy for his protest against the electric power, the dam in the northern part of Burma. That dam was intended to provide power supply to China. And just a few weeks ago, one of our colleagues, a video journalist, was sentenced for additional 10 years for using internet for uploading video footage for the exiled media. He had already been sentenced for 8 years with the Unlawful Association Act. Now, his sentence has been added for another 10 years. He is just a 20-year-old man. So, 18 years will be the waste period for him, for just a young man. Another matter of concern are ongoing tension in the ethnic border areas. Collapse of ceasefire agreement with the Kachin and in the Kachin and Chan state, and escalation of armed conflict. Just after the election, regime resumed the offensive to Karen, Shan, and Kachin state, resulting in serious human rights violations, including attacks against the civilian population, massive internal displacement, land confiscation, recruitment of child soldiers, forced labor, and portering for the army. During the past 2 months of fighting in Kachin state, Burmese soldiers have been raping women and young girls. Kachin Women Association in Thailand documented the rape of 14 women and girls in 8 townships, and 15 of whom have been killed after rape. That is a very grand picture of the Burma, but our colleagues inside the country never give up their struggle. The democracy movement happening in the Middle East inspired most of the young generation from Burma. We have seen, you know, the young generation is joining the NLD, joining the social network, and then, you know, they are pushing for reform. In our case, the regime is not enough for give promises if they are serious for national reconciliation. If they want to get international recognition, they must immediately stop torture, immediately stop rape, immediately stop summary execution in the ethnic area, and they must release more than 2,000 political prisoners and ensure them to participate in the political process. It has been for a long time, widespread and systematic human rights violation has been going on in Burma with impunity. Since 1991, I have been struggling to first a resolution on Burma at every section of the UN General Assembly and Human Rights Council. We already have piles of reports by the Human Rights Special Rapporteur. We already have several visits of the UN Special Envoy of the Secretary General to facilitate for dialogue. After 20 years, you know, we just see the words, not the deeds by the regime. So we need to keep up the international pressure. Of course, you know, that information and communication technology empower the